माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल इन माई बायो क्लास. माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव कम्प्लीटेड फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव नोटेड डाउन द नोट्स विच वेयर गिवन बाई मी टाइम टू टाइम अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रूटीन. इन दिस रिकॉर्ड आई एम गोइंग टू नाउ फोकस ऑन सम ऑडियो लेसन्स रिलेटेड टू द ऑल अबव डिस्कस टॉपिक्स. First of all, we will learn the definition of the reproduction. Reproduction is a biological process. Reproduction is a biological process in which organisms produce another organisms or offspring similar to itself. There are different two types of reproduction: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Come on, first. Asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction first is the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction are uniparental with or without gamete formation, and the offsprings are exact copies or clones of each other and parents. In asexual reproduction, mitosis is the essential mode of the cell division. There are different types of asexual reproduction. Number one, fission. Two is the fragmentation. Third is budding. Fourth one is the regeneration. Fifth one is spore formation. And sixth one, which occurs mostly in the plants, which is known as the vegetative propagation. We will discuss about the fission. Fission is a process in which there is the splitting of parental cells into two or more daughter cells. There are two types of fission. One is binary fission and multiple fission. In binary fission, there is the splitting of a parental cell into two equal daughter cells, and each of which rapidly grows into an adult. That type of fission is known as the binary fission. It occurs in single-celled animals. All single-celled animals means prokaryotes, mostly we can say, like amoeba, paramecium. It is very simple. So the first kind of fission which we have to see, it occurs in the unicellular organisms. It can be simple or irregular, longitudinal, oblique or transverse, depending on the plane of division. In the diagram you can see, this is the parental cells, amoeba. When it grows, the nucleus starts to elongate. The nucleus divides into two equal parts. There is the formation of a constriction between these two cells, and ultimately these cells divides and forms the new organism. By diagram now you can follow that there are the offsprings or the daughter cells which is formed. It is exact copy of their parent cell. These parent cells means that biologically, physiologically, genetically they are same. So they are commonly known as the clones. Now, we will discuss about the multiple fission. The splitting of parent cells into numerous daughter cells, each of which grows into an adult, is called multiple fission. Example is the Plasmodium. Just you can see the diagram. Here it is the microorganisms like Plasmodium. This Plasmodium, when it grows, matures, there, this means you can see that this nucleus divides into so many fragments. A single nucleus divides into so many fragments, hence it is known as multiple fission. As a result of which, there is the formation of numerous daughter cells. This is second type of fission. Now we will see the fragmentation. It is mode of asexual reproduction. इन विच द पेरेंटल बॉडी ब्रेक्स इंटू टू और मोर फ्रेगमेंट्स एंड ईच फ्रेगमेंट्स ग्रोज इंटू ए न्यू इंडिविजुअल एग्जाम्पल स्पायरोगायरा। स्पायरोगायरा जस्ट यू कैन सी द डायग्राम हियर इट इज द वन पेरेंट सेल्स। दिस पेरेंट सेल्स आफ्टर मैच्योरिटी ईच ब्रेक्स इंटू द फ्रेगमेंट्स एंड दिस फ्रेगमेंट्स इट इज एलिजिबल इट हैज पोटेंशियलिटी टू डेवलप इंटू द न्यू इंडिविजुअल्स लाइक द पेरेंट सेल्स। नेक्स्ट इज द बडिंग इन ईस्ट सेल्स द डिविजन इज अनइक्वल एंड स्मॉल बर्ड्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड। ए मीन्स ड्यूरिंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द बडिंग देयर इज अ डिफरेंसेज दैट्स वाई इट इज क्लियर इट शुड बी क्लियर that there is a formation of a buds and it remains attached initially to the parent cell which eventually gets separated and mature into new ist cell, whereas when we will talk about the hydra there is also a budding, but these parent cells when there is the formation of the buds these buds are totally detached after the maturity from the parent cells. Next one is known as the spore formation. These are motile spores having one or two flagella called zoospores. Zoospores are produced in a sac-like structure called zoosporangium. Example, Chlamydomonas. Spore formation, it is also of different types. In some cases, it forms the conidia. As you can see, it is the first of all you can see the diagram of the budding in yeast. Next one is the spore formation. Just you see how there is the formation of the zoospores in Chlamydomonas, and these spores it is in the form of conidia in case of Penicillium. And the next type of the asexual reproduction which you must know that is known as the gametes. It is also the asexual reproductive bodies which is found in the yes. Now we will discuss about the last which is known as the vegetative propagation. It is a mode of reproduction in which new plants are formed from the vegetative parts. Hence it is known as the vegetative propagules of the plant like root, stem, leaf, etc. Following are some units of vegetative propagules which you can see. That it is the name means the vegetative propagules, it is a unit from which the new plants will give rise. Bulbil is known as in agave, bulbs is known as in onion, eyes. My dear students, I think that all of you must very familiar to the potato. You have seen the eyes on it. These eyes, it is a vegetative propagules. Bryophyllum. The bryophyllum, what is the name of the vegetative propagules? It is the leaf buds. And in offset, it is you can see in the water hyacinths. Rhizome is the vegetative propagules by which it gives rise to the new plant. In ginger, runner, oxalis, sucker, mint. Now it becomes clear when you will see the diagram. Just you can see that a potato, it has the eyes. These eyes, it has the vegetative buds. These vegetative buds divides and it is able to give rise to the new plants. In the ginger, you can see that it can divide from the nodes. So all the examples which can say which in which we you can see that these are the vegetative propagules. The very important questions may be asked from it that the if the plants they gives rise to the new plants, so what is the mode of means division? The answer will be the node means each and every plants when they are in the vegetative propagules will form, it always forms at the nodes.